The news you count on. NBC2 News at 6.
Oh, this is just a little secret between us. That should be a really big red flag.
Secrets and bribes. Disturbing new information about sexual encounters between a teacher's assistant and a 12-year-old student. We told you when police arrested 32-year-old Lauren King last week. The Lee County School District then fired her from her job at Royal Palm Exceptional Center. The police report says she had sex with the boy and sent him texts with sexual images. You're watching NBC2. I'm Kelly Burns.
And I'm Peter Bush. Now investigators are concerned there could be more victims. NBC2 Samantha Serban is live outside downtown Fort Myers. And Samantha, I imagine a lot of our viewers are going to hear this new information and ask their kids some very difficult questions.
Right. It seems like Lauren King used every trick in the book, tried to keep the student who she's accused of molesting quiet. There was cash. There was gifts. There was even a threat of an arrest. Now, fortunately, when one of the victim's friends found out about the abuse, he reported it to Fort Myers police.
More than 4,000 texts in a matter of months. Police say 32-year-old Lauren King constantly sought out a 12-year-old boy. You need to always delete messages, King said. If they ever go through your phone, you're getting arrested, she threatened. I'm not coming back after the summer. You'll never see or hear from me and my fat can't make no friends kid. I fell in love with you. All of this while King was the victim's teaching assistant at Royal Palm Exceptional Center.
How often do you hear about sexual abuse in Lee County?
Unfortunately, that's my daily job.
Erica LaPue is a clinical therapist at Children's Advocacy Center. Not involved in the case, but often works with victims.
Is that victim ever going to get in trouble?
No, 100%. No, never. You're never going to go to jail. You're never going to get kicked out of school. All of those things that these perpetrators try to foster those lies, that's never going to happen.
A report from the National Children's Alliance shares nearly 14,000 cases of child sex abuse were reported in Florida in 2022. LaPue says predators use various methods to try to silence their victims. The report says King gave the victim money several times over Cash App, also an iPhone, computer, and Beats headphones under the guise of a birthday present. It wasn't until the boy's mentor caught King repeatedly calling him one day that the truth was revealed. King tried to get away, saying she'd quit her job and leave the area. The mentor recorded that conversation and called police. LaPue says this is an example of why having a safe adult to talk to is so important.
It can be really scary and it can be really intimidating to kind of open up. But when you take that first step, there are going to be people that are going to listen, they're going to care, and they're going to do what they have to do to make sure you're safe.
Police believe King may have other victims out there. In fact, the report says the victim heard rumors of other sexual relationships. If those victims are listening, here is LaPue's advice.
And there is light and positiveness on the other side of this that comes from sharing your story, where you can really move forward.
King was arrested last Thursday and is still in the Lee County Jail tonight.
And Samantha, did the therapist say anything about what clues that parents could look for that would send up warning flags for sexual abuse?
She says a big one is withdrawal. If your kid is isolating themselves away from friends or family, secrecy is another one. And having some big emotions, whether they be depressive or out of anger. But one thing LaPue wants all kids to know is there is never a secret that an adult and child should have where the child can't tell their parent or another safe adult. That is a huge red flag. I'm local in downtown Fort Myers. Samantha Serban, NBC2.